Hi everyone, welcome to the next video in a series where we'll be covering everything you need to know about IRL live streaming. In the last couple of videos, I showed you how to set up the streaming apps you need for your phone and home PC, and how to stream from one to the other using the best codec and protocol while on a local network. Today I'm going to show you how to use the Belabox Cloud service to stream from almost anywhere. If you've seen my other video on Belabox Cloud, we'll be covering lots of new ground, like how to stream with more than one phone at a time, and how to bond with another connection using your mobile phone. The best part, it's a lot easier than you think to get going, and bypasses all the issues you can have with port forwarding, blocked ports, dynamic IP addresses, firewall and VPN software, you name it. The only downside, it's a premium service that starts from $10 a month. But if you'd like a free alternative, there's a link in the description. For everyone else, let's start by signing up to the Belabox Cloud service. You do this by making a recurring donation on GitHub. Sign in or create a new GitHub account, then go to the sponsor page where you can select a tier. I've already got an account and plan, so here's an old clip showing what I did back then to do this. Use this as a guide, as some of the details have probably changed since then and by the time you watch this video. Anyway, to stream with one phone, go with the $10 a month plan, or to stream with two phones, there's a $20 plan. You choose this option if you plan on screen sharing another device, showing gameplay, photo editing like in this clip here, for multiple angles and more. For now, I recommend going with the $10 plan because you can always change it later. A $5 plan doesn't come with a SRT LA Relay server account, which is what you need for the rest of this video. After you've confirmed your plan and payment details, you'll get a confirmation page with steps on how to proceed. Read through everything carefully, then go to the Belabox Cloud website, log in with your GitHub to authorize Belabox, and complete your registration with an email and password. The homepage shows your Belabox sponsorship where you can change the tier you're currently on from, let's say, the $10 to $20 plan, and some other info. Most of what you'll see on the website is related to owning the Belabox hardware, which is a whole other topic we can leave for another time. For now, navigate to this link along the top of the page for SRT LA relays. But before you do anything else, don't share your account or stream key info with anyone, but just in case, there's a delete button to remove the old one and you're good to go again. Okay, let's move on. Depending if you're on the $10 or $20 plan, you can add one or two relay server accounts. I'm currently on the $10 plan, so this button won't let me add more than one account. I'll do the same for the $20 plan after you've added two. If you've got two accounts, you can choose one or the other using the drop-down box here. The first account is what you'd use for your primary streaming phone, but the second account for your other phone. The next step is to select the server. Since I'm in New Zealand, I've gone with AU Australia. Look through the list and choose a server that's nearest to you. You'll notice the page updates with settings for OBS Studio and some IRL apps for Android and iOS. But as you might remember in the intro, I mentioned connection bonding for mobile phones. For this, we'll need a special protocol type called SRTLA. You actually don't need to know what it means, but to look out for it in the URL field for each of the apps listed. Currently, IRL Pro for Android and Moblin for iOS support it. I'm sure this will change over time. Tap on the Add Automatically To button for IRL Pro or Moblin. I'll show you how to set up both apps side by side so you can follow along. A new browser tab or window will open where, at least for me, the IRL app settings can be found in the address bar. If it's blank for you like it is here, navigate to another browser tab and back again, where some text should now be visible in the address bar. Copy the text and send it to your phone in whatever secure way works for you. Open your IRL app, settings, import and export settings, paste the text you just copied, and then OK. You'll find the newly imported settings for IRL Pro in connections and for Moblin in streams. Make sure the new connection is enabled. Done. If you got Larix, the steps are basically the same, except you'd use the Add Automatically To Larix button instead. For Streamcaster and Streamcast Pro, use the Larix example to copy and paste what you need for your app. Create a new connection, name it Belabox Cloud, paste the URL with the stream key like in the example, and then save. The next step is to copy the settings for OBS Studio from the Belabox Cloud website. Look for OBS source URL near the top of the page. Tap on the URL field where it'll automatically copy the settings for you. No need to select and copy. Open OBS Studio with the scenes and sources we set up in the last video. On the Cam1 scene, double tap on the Cam1 media source to bring up its properties. For the import field, replace the existing SRT local link from last time with the URL you just copied from Belabox Cloud, and then OK. If you start streaming from your phone using the new connection, it should just work, whether you're connected to Wi-Fi, mobile, or both. Doesn't matter if you're at home, in another city or country, which is a pretty big deal. If you've seen my other video, you know what I mean. You also don't need to worry about any of the things I mentioned at the beginning of the video as well. It just works. Pretty cool, right? Anyway, connection bonding for IRL Pro should be as easy as connecting to the Wi-Fi of your other phone or hotspot. For Moblin, do this before you live stream. Also, make sure your stream is using the correct SRT LA link from the Belabox Cloud website, and that you've enabled connection priorities found in Settings, Streams, your Belabox Cloud stream, SRT outlay, and connection priorities. And two-fold setup is basically repeating the same steps as before. Just select the second account from the drop-down box. Scroll down the page, tap on the Add Automatically To button for whatever system your second phone uses, import the settings like before. Then copy the OBS source URL, create a new scene in OBS called Scene Cam 2 with a second Cam 2 media source using the same settings as the other one. Paste the URL you just copied from Belabox Cloud and then OK. Test the second account settings with your other phone and alternate between your primary and second phone to make sure you've got two working streams. You can even add a third scene with a picture-in-picture mode like in this clip here. I'm sure there's lots of other things you can do with this, but I'll leave the rest to you. Now don't blame me for thinking your job is done, but there's a couple of things that can break what we've done so far. Firstly, enable WebSocket server should be checked or enabled in Tools WebSocket server settings. Cross-check the SRT connection info for your phone and OBS Studio that you're using the correct info for both. This is especially important when you have two accounts and phones on different systems like me. Also, make sure you're using the nearest server for your area. If you travel a lot, you might have to update this regularly. With that, you can IRL live stream from one or two phones to your home PC, whether you're at home or abroad, or maybe with a bonded connection to boot. But we're missing one very important part of a remote connection, and that's disconnect protection. For now, what I recommend doing is adding a looping video under your media source like in this clip here. But there's usually a few seconds of nothing before disconnect protection actually kicks in and auto switches OBS to a BRB scene. We'll be covering disconnect protection using NoAlps in this video right here. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Like and share the video if you found it helpful. Otherwise, I'll see you over there.